Right. Welcome all. My name is Raymond, and this is Stream Gamers. We are going to do a flight with an Airbus A310. Now, the purpose of the video is more about, you know, walking through the steps necessary to fly the aircraft. The route is maybe not quite as important, but we'll be flying from Italy into Greece, and it's a short flight. I think it's about 300 nautical miles thereabouts. I'll give you the look at what the flight looks like once I get my stuff turned on. No, there. Yeah. So that's our flight. Along here and around here and down to here, and we're going to be coming in right in here. We'll be using the ILS, which is over here, Kalmata. So that's the flight. We are cold and dark on the tarmac here. At a parking spot, there we are. A310, Canadian Air Force. A310, they call it a CC-150 for the military purposes, but it is a A310. Right, so let's get some of the configuration out of the way. We'll look at the flight bag here and just make sure we got everything set. I am going to be carrying 229 passengers. 229. And we're going to carry some cargo, which is 5725. So this is cargo, so we'll call it 50.7. And fuel will be, oops, what happened here? What did I say? 57. There we go. And here we're going to carry 11.5 in the fuel. Confirm. Apply. So this is the plan that we're planning, right? And this is the actual live as it tracks fuel burn and so forth. So we apply that. The next steps are going to go to here, and then we're going to talk about Navigraph. So Navigraph, this is our flight plan that we're going to be flying. And this is the a bit more of a precise, you can see what it looks like, you know, what the part go around, come around here, and we're going to come in here. Now, we haven't actually selected our approach, and I've purposely not selected our approach, but we'll do that now. So we're going to be 3-5 left. Which one will we? That's, we could use a final. You know what, we'll go inside the flight inside the FM or MCDU and find the one that we want to use in there and pick it in relation to what is here. Oops, let's go to cancel that. So what we want to do now is we want to fill in. I keep seeing somebody going by here. I mean, I want to know what that's. Oh, that's a fuel truck. Okay. So what we want to do is we want to fill in all this data, and the goal is to be able to get our flex V1, V2, and VR and V2 speeds and so forth. And we need to fill this in to have that happen. So runway length, we're departing on 3-3. And so we will get runway length information, and where is runway, and we are departing on 3-3, right, forgot. 33 information. So 33 is 2,058 meters. 2,058. Enter. Heading 331. Just so you, the ICO code of the departing airport is LICR, and the arrival, should you decide to do this, is LGKL. Right, winds are 50 at 5. So 050 at 5. Temperature 11 degrees. QNH 1012. Whoops, that did not work. I don't know why it does that sometimes. 012. When I start clicking on the buttons, I don't actually click. Weight. That we get out of SimBrief. And our estimated takeoff weight is 114,094 kilograms. So our weight that we put in here is 119, and we always round. We always round to the nearest, so it would be 0.1. 15 flaps are going to be 15. It is dry, and the conditions are good, and everything else is fine. So when we calculate, now we get our flex. So that's our flex, our V1, VR, and V2 speed. We have that now. And we've got our center of gravity, and we've got what we're intending to have for our trim, which is 0.1. Percent, right? So we got 9 here, so we're intending to have 0.1%. And so when I change that, it will change later on once I get some power to the aircraft. So let's go through the power up. Where are they? Batteries. There we go. I'm going to get this out of the way. This is your iris alignment. Let me get that set up and started. Then our next trick, or our next step, is to enable ground. That powers everything up. We'll put these fuel pumps on. We'll get the APU up and running. And we'll make sure we hit bleed after APU is up and running, and just before we get ready to start engines. So the next step is, yes, we want to do the alignment, but before we do that, we want to bring in the flight. We're going to bring in the flight plan, and I have the flight plan in SimBrief. For those that don't know SimBrief, just by all means go and have a look at it, and you'll see, that you can put your flight plans in using SimBrief, and then once you're here, you hit the alignment, and that should align your instruments, which it does. We are using CAF 444, which is our flight ID. We calculated our V speeds, which are right here. Go to there. So 135, 135, 136, and 41. So 135. Oops. Hang on. Before I get too far into this, I forgot I need to go into here. Click on this. Our fuel block, which I said was 11.5. Center of gravity, that is our zero fuel weight, I should say, which is 104.0. So, 104.0. So that sets that. Our center of gravity, which we get from that back over here and here, and there it is, 25.7. 25.7. Okay, now we can come back in here, and that was 135. That was 136. And then we're going to go back up to the overhead, and we're going to put yaw damper on, pitch trim on, ATIS and ATIS back. And then once we've done that, we have our autopilot panel illuminated and up. And so the reason why I did that is because here we see our V2 rotate speed, 141. And what we always do is we just want to make sure that we want to make sure that we're 10 knots above what's shown in there. And that's what I'm going to be putting in. Just move that out of the way, We'll just get that started, that get going, okay. So that's what I want to put in here, is the 151. So I'm going to just dial in 151. There's 151. Let's find out what our cruise altitude will be, 29,000. So we'll put that in there. You can click these, but the up button for thousands, or the down knob for hundreds. So, the up button, and then press the up button again to go to thousands, to 29,000. So we got that set. Our heading, we will look at our runway again, which is 331. So we'll put our heading to 331. Oh, went too far. 331. Oops. So I always put the heading in here of the runway that I plan on departing on, so I have that if I were to lock on heading hold here, then it would just grab that heading and hold it. And likewise, I'll have the throttle set and the altitude climb up and all that stuff set. Okay. So let's do a quick review here. We'll make sure that we pick our SID. So our SID, our departure is 33. And I believe it's that one that we want. So let me just verify that. Here, SIDs. One T, right? Yeah, this is the one that we're right here. Click that, we'll insert that in. So now we got that. And then we will come down here to our arrival, and we'll decide our arrival. There's our arriving airport, there's our star. So our arrival. Our arrival is ILS Zulu 335 left, or 35 left, and then we want, which one do we want? F, and we want this one right here. So we'll insert that. So now we'll go through the flight plan and just make sure there's no discontinuities, no things like vector or stuff like that. We'll just go through it all, no manuals, no issues with the flight plan. It looks pretty good. Back to the beginning of the flight plan. And then now we'll kind of step it through using this display right here. So we can kind of see, you know, our path that we're intending to go. So I had this last time, I had this weird anomaly in here. It's wanting us to come to this VOR, which is at the airport, and we don't need to come to the VOR, so we can clear that out. Let's get that gone. Clear that discontinuity out. So we come down here and we come in, and this is kind of a missed after the fact approach and all that good stuff. We could take that all out. If you look here, this is the runway where we landed. Anything past that would be like a missed approach, and so you'd apply this so-called missed approach. We'll leave that in. We don't care about that. We got that set. It looks like we are pretty close to being ready to... Yeah, I think we're ready to go. I'm just going to do one more quick review of the MCDU just to make sure that I haven't missed anything or forgotten about anything. Yeah, I don't think so. Our radios are... Oops, let me get that armrest out of the way. There's our radios. So later on, once we need to set our radios, we can set them down here for the ILS. No, sorry, that's not for the ILS. There's the ILS up here. These are our comm radios, and this is the ILS VR navigation radios right here, right? So those are comms down there. Okay. So let's, I do that wrong every time. Okay. So we're going to push back, and because it's such a, it's really a short push back, my intentions are to kind of push it back and turn it this way. Because we're taking off, we're departing up over there somewhere. So we can either push back straight here and then kind of taxi this weird zigzag thing, or we can just make a turn and taxi down here, taxi on the runway, which is probably what I'm going to attempt to do, which requires a pretty sharp turnout. So don't know if I'll be able to push it back and turn that sharp, but we're going to try it. So on here, there is a push back on here. Our APU should be lit and ready to go. It is armed. We should have APU gen is on. So we should be able to disconnect ground power, which we've done. I'm going to fire up the fuel pumps. There they go. Now we're going to push it back. And like I say, we're going to push it back. And the plan is to push it back. I'm just going to get my taxi chart here. I use the, I can turn that on so you guys can see what I'm looking at here. That one. So yeah, there's the taxi chart that I use. So you can see here's where we're parked and here's where our departure is right here. So the plan is probably, I've changed my mind, I'm just going to push it back this way and we'll just taxi out this way and back taxi on the runway. It's probably not the way we're supposed to do it. Or maybe what we'll do is we'll just push it back and then do a U-turn here. I think that's what I'll do. Yeah, okay. Let's do that. So that being said, I'm not so comfortable with the pushing back and starting all at the same time, because the pushback is going to be really short. So I'll complete the pushback and then I'll do the start. So there's my pushback. cushion. It'll straighten up a bit. So I'm going to stop it here. I'm going to put the brakes on. Brakes are on. Now we'll begin our start. How do we start? We make sure our bleed is turned on right there. We put this to crank. That valve goes to open. Basically what that's doing is that's sending air from the APU to this engine, and you can see it slowly starting to spin, and as it spins N1 is climbing. At some point, once N1 is up and N2 is at 24, so now we will push fuel in, and we should see N2 climbing up, and N1 is climbing. What we're going to get here shortly is this is going to go back to the arm position, arm or off, I can't remember now, but it'll switch positions. Yeah, there is a definitive click sometimes. There it is. I was talking through it, but there it is. It's click. Let's go start the second engine. And likewise, what's happening right now is it's spinning up, and we're seeing the N2 to climb here. You're supposed to at around, I think it's at 19 is where you're technically supposed to introduce fuel, 19 to 20. So that's good enough. Let's introduce fuel. There's fuel. And we'll see this climb up. The EGT will start to climb up. You see how the EGT is up here. So this is all going to start climbing up. So it's armed, it's ready to go. We're going to put this to continuous. We're going to disengage the APU. We'll shut down the bleed. We'll turn on probe heat. We'll turn on window heaters. We'll turn on air supply for the oxygen. And we are pretty much ready to start our taxi, short of putting in our trim. If I remember correctly, that was what was our trim supposed to be? Does anybody tell me that? No. Right there. One. Oh, wait. I'll get it eventually. Down one notch. So as we said, we're gonna do a U-turn. Basically, you're gonna do a 180 degree turn here and taxi out. Brakes are off. And here we go. Just starting to spool it up a bit. Bit of a balancing between over throttling and overdoing rudder to make a turn like this. That's a little over throttle because the nose is starting to push a little bit rather than turn. There we go. So we're configured. I'm going to hit my nav. I'll engage my profile, my auto throttle. And we are. Give it just a bit more go. As I said before, the game plan is to back taxi on the runway, and we'll turn around. There's runway 35. We'll just take a quick little peek here just to make sure it's safe. Nobody. Nobody. Obviously, we would be using ATC. Sorry, I'm a little distracted. There's a couple of things I'm trying to do here at the same time. I'm watching a chat program here as well, and I'm not so good at this multitasking. I'm far from an expert streamer, I will say that much. So, here we go. Careful not to be going too quick, because you ideally don't want to be slamming on the brakes when you're at the other end, but still like to get to the other end. So, the game plan here is, after we get lined up, is we will push the throttles forward, we will rotate at in around 140 knots, thereabouts, possibly a little quicker. Here we go. Okay. little squirrely. Yeah, the departure was a little squirrely. But we got positive rate of climb. Gear up. Engage the autopilot. Flaps are up. So there we go. We are on our way. Got about, let's go find out exactly what we have. We look at the FMC or MCDU. That's what I forgot to initialize, didn't I? There's 392 miles to the destination. So we're going to climb up. We're climbing out to our 29,000 feet. And there is, if you see here, let me show it. Well, you'll be able to see it, maybe it's more like it. Oh, yeah, there it is. It's kind of hard to see it, but there's a little blue arrow right there. That little blue arrow is your top of climb. And you're going to see another arrow that's kind of turned the other way, which is your top of descent. So we're going to we're going to let this thing go. And probably in about 20 minutes or so, probably 30 minutes or so, we'll be at our near our top of descent. And then we'll start discussing the preparation necessary to begin our descend and our approach and final and all that good stuff. So what I'm going to do is, you're more than welcome to kind of skip through this as far as you like, and pick up the video wherever you like to pick it up from. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my camera off and mute the mic. And I will let you guys take in whatever scenery is to be taken in. And I'm going to take a small little break. And we'll catch up when we get ready for our descending. All right. So I will talk shortly. Once I figure out what I'm doing. Right there.
are trying to throw me off, right?
Nicorette gum relieves nicotine cravings fast.
Okay. Well, I'm here. We're just getting ready for our top of descent. So positioned here. So if we look down at the instrument down here, you can see we're about 20 miles from top of descent. So our initial altitude will be 3,000, but we're actually coming down to 2,000 for the ILS. So we've put that in. We're going to program our ILS frequency, 111.3. We'll do that down here. Keep an eye on that. Here it is. There we go. So once this gets right close to that, we're going to press the down arrow. So the down arrow is to engage the descend. And the up arrow is to change from increments of 1,000 to increments of 100. But yes, so we'll just wait till we get a little closer. We're still, it's in increments of 10, so we are still, right, there's the 10-mile marker, here's the 5-mile marker. And if we programmed everything right, we will be in good shape at our threshold. As I showed before, we want to be ultimately our final will be our final approach will be 2,000 feet, and so that's why I've programmed it for 2,000 feet. The FMC should adhere to all speed slash and restrictions along the way. So, for example, here it wants to be 0.78 Mach at 29,000. There it wants to be 286 at 26 in list, and goes on and on and on. So it should, in theory, should do it. We're just about to top of descent, so I'm just going to get ready here to get ready to push the button. And it's not really an exact science, but there it is. It's been clicked. You can see the altimeter, the altitude indicator coming down, and we're on our way down. What should happen is over here, you should see the engines come back, either to idle or close to idle, as we begin our descent. We are probably descending in that neighborhood of 3 degrees or so. Actually, we're descending quite a bit faster than that, but we'll pick up on that. It should descend somewhere around 2,500 feet per minute. But keep in mind when you're doing this, the MCDU and the flight management system of it understands to what descent rate it should be going based on the speed slash distance in order to get you to that 2,000 feet. At the beginning of the threshold, and if everything is done correctly, it will. Now I'm told that this aircraft can do an auto land. I've never been successful in getting one done. So for those who are watching the video, if you understand how it works, by all means, please make a comment about it. Let me know how I go about doing that. It would be greatly appreciated. And of course, you know, all that comment, like, subscribe, blah, blah, blah stuff that everybody asks you to do. I would appreciate it if you did it. Not a requirement, but I would appreciate it. I don't necessarily care about algorithms and what YouTube thinks. It just tells me whether I'm on the right track in producing videos for people that want to see them or not. So, somewhere's in here. want to look at, right, distance. Turn this off for a second. I'll make some adjustments here quickly. Just give me a moment. Technical difficulties here, but I think I got it figured out. Okay. Now, back up a little bit. So, we're coming here. This is going to be a come a 180, and that's what I'm a little more, I'm a little worried about that 180 coming out around here and then coming back in. But if we go slow enough, we should be able to do it. There's the hope, anyways. Along, let's go off of standard. Oops, one button, there we go. Let's get that set. And there's land. So we left, can't see it, but in that distance up there is Italy, where we left, and this is the coast of Greece. Am I looking at this right? I think I am. Yeah, that's right. So we're going to fly. Fly kind of over top of here somewhere. If I'm thinking that one of these two little pins right here is the actual airport that we're arriving on. That'd be my guess. Pretty sure of it. And so when you're flying these aircraft that are basically self-managing themselves, I've done almost zero control work since we took off. Once I hit the autopilot, the aircraft has pretty much done everything by itself, with the exception of measuring where top of descent is and making sure that I'm ready to, you know, come down. My top of descent, and then I look at Navigraph to kind of give me what is that initial, like right now, if I were showing you the charts, it would probably be telling me that I should be somewhere around, my guess is somewhere around 9,000 or so. What am I? What is my actual altitude? Yeah, 12,000. Let me just verify that. So we're on our way for CF3LZ, So here's where we're on our way to. So we're trying to get down to 3,000 feet at 214 knots is what we're trying to do. Which may be a bit of a problem, because here's the issue that I have. I did alter the flight plan to begin with, so I feel like that may cause some problems. We've got 26 miles or 26 nautical miles to go. And in that 26 nautical miles, we've got to lose about 8,000 feet. But most importantly, we've got to drop a whole whack of speed here. And it's trying to do that if you see that little arrow coming down. Now, I can help facilitate that a little bit, which I'm doing right now. What I'm doing is using the speed brake. For those that need to pull the, it's right here. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get myself caught up a little bit here so I can get closer to my 200 knot, 214 knot speed that it's trying to achieve, and while still trying to maintain some kind of descent rate so that I can also get my 3,000 where I'm supposed to be at. Right, we looked at this here, where this is where we're going to right here, and here are the here's what it's trying to achieve, 214 at 3,000. But we're at our 215 marker right now. I'm going to pull the speed brakes off again, and I'm going to let it continue to descend. Because we got from 250 here down to our 214, we only got 30-ish knots to drop. That's the airport. Yep, that's the airport down there. The bigger of the two. There's two of them down there. This one here, and then this one. This is the one we're coming in on right here. That's the runway we're going to approach. And it's going to take us out. It's going to take us out of fairways. And that's so that it can make that, because it has to make basically a 180 degree turn back in, right? So it's going to take us out, somewhere out to here. This little Yeti here that jets out. That's where we're going to turn around, begin our turnaround, according to what I'm looking on the map. So I guess I could dial this in a bit and see where that actually is. Yeah. So this is us right here. We begin the turn here, even though the waypoint is there. I'm not sure why. We're not too terribly far off profile, I can see here. We're a little off, but we're not horrible. And we won't be doing an auto landing, although, like I said before, I'm told that this thing can do. I just haven't been able to successfully get it to do that. And not to mention the weather conditions. When you look at the weather conditions, you know, auto landing, I'm presuming auto landing is more needed in adverse weather and you have to land type of thing. You can see that the skies are clear, everything is crystal clear for me, so I should not have any problems seeing the runway and getting it to land. We're down to 5,600 feet, so again, I think we're in pretty good shape. I wish my speed would bleed off a bit more. What's our distance to that waypoint? Yeah, see, we're 5 miles to that waypoint, and we need to be at that waypoint here. We need to be going 214. So at some point, it's going to want to start losing speed. Here's our turnaround. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to control the speed myself, because I don't trust this much. speed breakout. Really want it to achieve. So our diamond, you see the diamond coming up here. That's because we're descending hopefully fast enough. I feel like we're going to be a little high, but I don't think we're going to have too terribly much of an issue with being a little high. So we're in flap range. Let's put the gear down. Let's get that gear down. Let's give it one notch, maybe two. It's going to help us here a little bit. Just the turn and the realignment and all of that good stuff. Medium. That's where we're trying to line up to. 3,000. Yeah, I think we're in some pretty solid shape here. Trying to pull itself back into the alignment of the ILS right now, I think. Nope. Looks like it is. Yeah. Okay. So like I said, I think we were going to be a little high, and we are, but that's okay. What I can do now is I can just disengage the autopilot and bring it in. So I'm going to get a little quiet now because I need to focus and try to concentrate.
Sync rate.
And we're here. We've arrived. So we'll start to clean up just a little bit. So, this tutorial, see how I do it, is not intended to be the gospel as to how you actually fly the A310, because I'm certainly not an A310 pilot, but it is intended to help those that are trying to learn how to fly this thing, trying to figure out how to program an FMC, how to, you know, do a cold and dark startup for those that are interested in it. You know, what are the steps necessary? Now, all of the things that I use, Little Math Map, SimBrief, and Navigraph, none of those things are really, really needed. I mean, you can look at the MCDU, pick a runway, then the runway that you pick, those SIDs will be associated to that runway. So you will be taking off. You may not be going in the right direction, you know, because if you want to take off and go east, you may be picking a SID that's going west. So be mindful of that. But the point of the conversation isn't that you actually have to have these tools in order to fly. And as I said, I'm not trying to suggest that I know exactly how we fly an A310, because that isn't the case. This is just how I do it. For those that have pointers and how I might do it better, by all means, put a comment in the comment section. I would be happy to read that and understand what I could do better. If you have a request for how to fly a particular aircraft and I have it in my inventory and I know it, I'm happy to put together a tutorial and A, try to figure it out with you, or B, if I know it already, I'll put a tutorial together and say this is how I do it. And so I would appreciate any comments, like, subscribes to the video. We will probably put together one of the next videos that I'm actually intending to put together is an instructional video on how to do general aviation type flights instead of airlines. I do a lot of airline flying, but that's just me, and I know other people, you know, want to fly other aircraft other than just airlines. So I will, I'm going to park it right here. So that's my game plan. My game plan is to try to put together an informational video on most of the general aviation type aircraft. Most of them kind of work more or less the same. And so I'll pick one. If there's one that you guys particularly want, list a comment, put it in a comment, those that read this or see the video, put it in the comments, and if there's one clear winner, and that be the one we use. Right, my name is Raymond, this is Stream Gamers. Appreciate your time and watching it, and liking, commenting, and subscribing, and all that good stuff. And until the next one, thanks for watching.